Good morning, students. Today we are going to discuss about the example of chapter number 12. Before that, already we have discussed two examples, 12.1 and 12.2. So today we are going to discuss about 12.3, 4, 5 and 6. So let's start the question number 3, 12.3. In question, what is given? How much current will an electric bulb draw from a 220 volt source if the resistance of the bulb filament is 1200? How much current will an electric heater coil draw from a 220 volt source if the resistance of the heater coil is 100? Now, abhi question mein kya diya hai? We have to find the amount of current. Abhi question mein find out kya karna hai? क्वेश्चन में फाइंड करना है करंट. अब करंट कब फाइंड करना है? तो करंट पे फाइंड आउट करना है जब V का वैल्यू होगा 220 एंड द वैल्यू ऑफ R विल बी 1200. सो नाउ इन द सेकंड वन अगेन वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट द वैल्यू ऑफ I व्हेन द V विल बी 220 एंड R विल बी 100. सो नाउ लेट्स स्टार्ट द क्वेश्चन. हाउ द क्वेश्चन कैन बी सॉल्व? तो ये क्वेश्चन को हम लोग दो पार्ट में कवर करेंगे. First we will solve A, then second we will solve B. So first in A, what is given? I हमें find out करना है 220 voltage दिया हुआ है और R का value कितना दिया 1200. तो let's see what is given. तो first V का value कितना दिया 220 volt and R कितना दिया 1200. So according to Ohm's law, what is Ohm's law? V equal to IR. So now here V equal to IR. So V kitna diya 220 volt. What is R? R equal to 1200. So what we have to find? I. So I equal to V upon R. So put the value of V. V equal to 220 volt and the R will be 1200. So now divide both the terms. What we will get? We will get 0.18 ampere. So current ka value kitna hoga? 0.18 ampere. So now here, the first A part we have solved. Now the second part again, we have to solve the same question, but here, the value of V is 220 and the R will be 100. Again, we have to find the value of I. So now, what is given? V equal to 220 volt and R equal to 100. So again, according to Ohm's law, V equal to IR, V is given 220 and R is given 100. So again, so convert the formula V equal to IR in I form. I equal to V upon R. So V equal to 220 and R equal to 100. Now divide both the terms. When we will divide both the terms, what we will get? We will get 2.2 ampere. So now the question number third is completed, both the part A and B. Now again we will solve the question number 4. Now see, in question number 4, what is given? So question number 4 mein kya diya hua hai? So sabse pehle we will read the question. The potential difference between the terminal of an electric heater is 60 volt when it draw a current of 4 ampere from the source. What current will the heater draw if the potential difference is increased to 120 volt. So now ye question mein kitna diya hai? Potential difference between the terminal of an electric heater. Electric heater ke beech mein jo potential difference hai wo kitna hai? 60 volt. Aur uske andar current kitna pass out ho raha hai? 4 ampere. So now what current will be heater draw? Now again what we have to find? We have to find the value of I when the potential difference is increased to 120 volt. तो अगर क्वेश्चन में पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस को 60 से 120 वोल्ट पे इंक्रीज किया जाएगा तो व्हाट विल बी द वैल्यू ऑफ आई, तो ये हमें फाइंड आउट करना है. तो नाउ अगेन वी विल सी कि क्वेश्चन में क्या क्या दिया हुआ है हमें. तो फर्स्ट द पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस बिटवीन द टर्मिनल ऑफ एन इलेक्ट्रिक हीटर इज 60 वोल्ट. तो नाउ वी इज गिवन टू अस, वी का वैल्यू दिया हुआ है. एंड अगेन व्हेन इट ड्रो अ करंट ऑफ 4 एम्पीयर, तो करंट का वैल्यू बी हमें दिया हुआ है, आई इक्वल टू 4 एम्पियर. So now what current will the heater draw if the potential difference is increased to 120? तो अगर यहाँ पे potential difference that is V, अगर V को increase करेंगे 120 तो current का value कितना होगा? तो again same we can solve. What is V? V is given. V equal to 60 volt. I कितना दिया? 4 ampere. So again according to Ohm's law हमें पता है Ohm's law का equation क्या होता है? V equal to I है. तो यहाँ पे V का value कितना दिया है? 60. I कितना दिया है? 4 ampere. तो यहाँ से हमें क्या मिल जाएगा? Here we will get R. तो R equal to V upon I. तो V का value कितना है? 60. I का value कितना है? 4. Then 60 divided by 4. What is the answer? 15 for the 60. तो answer will be 15 ohm. So now here the first part is completed. But when the potential difference is increased to 120 volt. तो जब पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस को 60 से 120 वोल्ट पे इंक्रीज किया जाएगा तो व्हाट विल बी द वैल्यू ऑफ आई? तो अगेन विद द सेम फॉर्मूला अकॉर्डिंग टू ओम्स लॉ आई इक्वल टू वी अपॉन आर. वी का वैल्यू कितना दिया है? तो द वैल्यू ऑफ वी इज 120 एंड व्हाट इज द वैल्यू ऑफ आर? तो हियर वी गॉट द वैल्यू ऑफ आर दैट इज 15 ओम. सो नाउ हियर पुट द वैल्यू 15. सो 120 divided by 15 that is 8 ampere. Now the next question, question number 5, 12.5. So now we will read the question. In question what is given? Resistance of a metal wire of length 1 meter is 26 ohm at 20 degree Celsius. If the diameter of the wire is 0.3 mm, what will be the resistivity of the metal at that temperature? Using table 12.2 predict the material of the wire. So now in question mein kya diya hai? Ek wire hai jiska length hai 1 meter and R ka value mein diya hua hai. The value of R is 26 ohm and temperature kitna diya? 20 degree Celsius. Aur wire ka diameter bhi diya hua hai. Kitna? 0.3 mm. And what we are supposed to find? We have to find the value of rho, that is resistivity. And resistivity of the metal at that temperature using, and हमें ये भी identify करना है कि जो metal है तो metal कौन सा है? Copper, silver, manganese. Let's solve the question. So now resistance of a metal wire length कितना दिया? 1 meter. What is the value of R? 26. Diameter 0.3 mm. Then resistivity we have to find. Now see. R equal to 26, L equal to 1 meter, D that is diameter 0.3 mm. But यहाँ पे question में diameter की requirement नहीं है, तो हम क्या करेंगे? Diameter को radius में convert करेंगे. तो हमें पता है radius कितना होगा? Diameter का half, तो 0.15 mm. But यहाँ पे question किस में दिया है? mm में. तो हमें किस में चाहिए? हमें चाहिए meter में. तो 0.15 mm convert into meter that is 1.5 into 10 to the power minus 4 meter. तो ये हमने इसको convert कर दिया meter में. But now अब question में solve out करना है resistivity. तो resistivity का formula क्या होता है? So first हमने last time discuss किया था कि resistance कौन कौन सी चीजों पर depend है. तो resistance is depend on the length of the wire, cross section area. So now R equal to rho L upon A. But ये formula में कौन से terms में चाहिए? रेजिस्टिविटी के टर्म्स में. तो रेजिस्टिविटी इक्वल टू आर इंटू ए अपॉन एल. सो नाउ अकॉर्डिंग टू फॉर्मूला रेजिस्टिविटी इक्वल टू आर इंटू ए अपॉन एल. सो आर का वैल्यू कितना दिया? 26. बट ए दैट इज एरिया. हमें यहाँ पे क्वेश्चन में एरिया का रिक्वायरमेंट नहीं, बट जो मेटल है मेटल का क्रॉस सेक्शन कैसा होगा? राउंड फॉर्म में. तो राउंड फॉर्म का एरिया कितना होगा? दैट इज सर्कल. सर्कल का एरिया कितना होगा? पाई आर स्क्वायर. सो एरिया की जगह क्या लिखेंगे? पाई आर स्क्वायर. सो आर 26, एरिया पाई आर स्क्वायर, एल दैट इज 1 meter. सो नाउ पुट द वैल्यू ऑफ ऑल द गिवन वैल्यूज. सो 26 इंटू पाई दैट इज 3.14. पाई का वैल्यू कितना होता है? 3.14. देन आर स्क्वायर, तो रेडियस कितना दिया? 1.5 इंटू 10 टू द पावर माइनस 4. तो 1.5 इंटू 10 टू द पावर माइनस 4 का स्क्वायर. So now again 26 into 3.14, now 1.5 into 10 to the power minus kis mein diya hai? Square mein diya. So now what we will do, we will solve the square. So 1.5 ka square kitna hota hai? 2.25, then 10 to the power minus 8. So 26 into 3.14 into 2.25 into 10 to the power minus 8. So now multiply all the values. So hume kya mil jayega multiply karne ke baad? 183.69 multiply by 10 to the power minus 8. Now convert the decimal after one digit. So now what we will get? Hume kya mil jayega? 1.83 into 10 to the power minus 6. So now the last answer. What is the resistivity of the material? So 1.83 into 10 to the power minus 6. But now the question is given. We can predict the material of the metal. So for this we have to go for the table number 12.2. Again, now we will solve one more question, 12.6. Now we will read the question. What is given? A wire of given material having length L and area of cross section A has a resistance of 4 ohm. What would be the resistance of another wire of the same material having length L by 2 and area of cross section is 2A? So now, हमारे पास यहाँ पे एक वायर है. वायर का लेंथ कितना है L. वायर का लेंथ कितना है L. एरिया कितना है A. And what is the value of R? 4 ohm. So now again, what we have done? Now again, the length of the same wire is converted into half, L by 2. एक वायर था जिसका लेंथ था L, एरिया था A, and what is the value of R? 4. So now again the same wire, but the length is different, L by 2, area is double, 2A, then we have to find out the value of R. So now again, we will solve the question. We will take the first wire, then we will take the second wire. Now, the first wire, for first wire, R equal to resistivity L upon A equal to 4 ohm. It is given R1 equal to rho L upon A equal to 4 omega. It is given. Now, but the same wire, but the length is half and the area is double. Now, for the second wire, R2 equal to rho, the length is L by 2 and area is double, 2A. So now for the second wire, R2 equal to rho L by 2 upon 2A. So now what we will do? L upon 2, 2 ko niche le aayenge. So now we will get 2 to the 4. So 1 by 4 resistivity L upon A. So now from the first wire, the condition was R1 equal to resistivity L upon A equal to 4 omega. So now here instead of 1 upon 4 resistivity L upon A, instead of resistivity L upon A, we will place 4. So R2 equal to 1 upon 4 into 4. Now the 4 will be cancelled, 4 and the 4. So now the value of R2 equal to 1 ohm. Instead of resistivity L upon A, we have placed 4. Why? Because in question it was given resistivity L upon A equal to R1. And what is the value of R1? That is 4 omega. So now put the value R2 equal to 1 upon 4 into 4. 4 1 is 4, then 1 into 1. That is 1. R2 equal to 1 ohm. So now this way the question number 3, 4, 5, 6, all the questions we have solved in a very easy and simple manner. So to learn this type of questions in a very simple and easy way, how the question can be solved in an easy way, for this, like the video, subscribe it and share with your friends.